Hi everyone, I'm back again. We're going to be looking today at medullary-sponge-kidney. Earlier we were looking at another condition, but this time I'm going directly to the osmosis.org website, and we're just going to be looking at one MCQ and a few flashcards. Jupiter and Mars. And we have some music. Hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Okay, so let's go to the website. We're going to osmosis.org, and I'm going to input medullary sponge kidney and see what we come up with. So first, let's look at the definition for medullary sponge kidney. Medullary sponge kidney is unusually benign congenital renal disorder characterized by cystic dilatation of the collecting tubules in one or both kidneys. So right off the bat, let's remember that this is a problem with the collecting tubules in one or both kidneys. And individuals with medullary sponge kidney are at increased risk for kidney stones and urinary tract infection. So on the website, they have a video. We're not going to look at the video. Listen to the video. We're going to go directly to a question. So I'm just going to look at the Quiz Me Now section. Okay, so this is coming up. But before that, this was Harold and Kumar, the soundtrack from the first one. It's a great movie if you haven't seen it. Anyway, this is a perfect background song, I think, for looking at these types of questions. So let's get to it. Okay, we're going to be looking at this question. A 28-year-old woman comes to the office because of blood in her urine. She has a history of urinary tract infections. She says she feels abdominal pain and on occasion nausea with the pain. An intravenous pyelogram is done and shows hyperdense papillae and small clusters limited to the calyces, as shown similarly to the diagram below, which you can't see, but I'm looking at some cysts, and it says that the clusters are confirmed to be calcium stones. Which of the following is the most likely cause? So that's the question. So, A, congenital disorder causing cystic dilatation of the collecting tubes, or dilation of the collecting tubules. B, dysfunctional production of protein Mekelin. And C, inadequate reabsorption in the proximal renal tubules. D, mutation in the gene encoding for polycystin 1. E, under excretion of uric acid. So which of these five choices is the correct answer? Okay, remember, I'm going to read the stem again. 20-year-old woman, she has blood in her urine, she has a history of urinary tract infections, she says she feels abdominal pain and on occasion nausea with the pain. An intravenous pyelogram is done and shows hyperdense papillae, small clusters limited to the calyces, as shown similar to the diagram below, which you can't see. So which is the cause? Is it a problem with polycystin 1? No, because that is from the previous podcast I did tonight with the autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease, if I'm correct. Is it dysfunctional protein? Is it dysfunctional production of the protein Mekelin? I don't think so. Is it a congenital disorder causing cystic dilation of the collecting tubules? Yes, I think it's that. So we'll choose that. Am I sure? Feeling lucky or no clue? I'm sure. Okay, yes, it's correct. Congenital disorder causing cystic dilation of the collecting tubules. So the major takeaway Medullary sponge kidney is a benign congenital disorder leading to cystic dilatations of the collecting tubules of one or both kidneys. Although often asymptomatic, it can be associated with recurrent urinary tract infections and kidney stones that cause pain and hematuria. Everybody's talking at me. Okay, I don't know if you remember what movie that's from. But let's move on to the main explanation. Medullary sponge kidney is a congenital disorder characterized by dilated collecting tubules. Please remember this. The collecting tubule dilatation or ectasia is associated with the formation of medullary cysts which do not involve the cortex of the kidney. Although it is a congenital disorder, it is most often asymptomatic until adulthood when it is discovered while investigating another issue such as hematuria or recurrent urinary tract infections. Patients with medullary sponge kidney often form calcium phosphate matter in the cysts, which promotes nephrocalcinosis, the production of kidney stones. Although medullary sponge kidney is benign, increased risk of morbidity is often associated with frequent kidney stones and recurrent UTIs. The cystic dilations of the medullary sponge kidney are often visualized using intravenous pyelography. I'm going where the sun keeps shining through the pouring rain. Going where the weather suits my clothes. Banking off of the north. Okay, so we know what the answer is now, but what if we'd chosen some of the other choices? For example, dysfunctional production of protein Mekelin. What is that? Meckel syndrome is a rare lethal genetic disorder caused by the defective production of proteins MSK1 and Mekelin. These proteins are required for cilia formation, and deficiencies result in serious conditions like renal cystic dysplasia, central nervous system malformations, hepatic developmental defects, and pulmonary hypoplasia. Okay, what if you had thought it was an inadequate reabsorption in the proximal renal tubules? Fanconi syndrome is due to inadequate reabsorption of essential molecules like glucose, amino acids, phosphate, and bicarbonate. It can arise congenitally or acquired. The loss of bicarbonate in the urine causes renal tubular acidosis, and the loss of phosphate can cause rickets or osteomalacia. So this is quite a common question, Stem, when you see someone with rickets as a child, osteomalacia later on. And the problem with the proximal renal tubule is Fanconi syndrome. How about if you thought it was a mutation in the gene encoding for polycystin 1? Polycystic kidney disease is one of the top hereditary diseases in the United States due to mutations in the genes that code for polycystin 1. It is characterized by the presence of multiple cysts in both kidneys and, unlike in medullary sponge kidney, are not limited to the calyces. So here's a big point here, right? That it's limited to the calyces. And how about this choice? If you had said under excretion of uric acid. The under-excretion of uric acid is the predominant cause of gout. Deposition of uric acid crystals can cause painful inflammation in the joints. Deposition of uric acid crystals also occurs in the kidney, also leading to pain and eventually can lead to kidney failure. So we went over the question here, and I think we could also have a look at the flashcards. They offer 4 flashcards here. Oh, it started the video. Okay. I'm not going to listen to that, although I have listened to it and the videos are excellent. Let's see if we listen to that one. Listen to something else. I want to listen to Glenn Campbell because I really like Glenn Campbell. He recently passed away a few days ago, and he was just an amazing singer. I've been walking these streets so long, singing the same old song. I know every crack in these dirty sidewalks of
the name of the game. And nice guys get washed away like the snow and the rain. There's been a load of compromising on the road to my horizon. But I'm gonna be where the lights are shining on me. Like a
I love that song. Okay, so let's look at the flashcards that come with this question for medullary sponge kidneys. The first one says complications in medullary sponge kidney include three. So can you think of three of the complications in medullary sponge kidney? So the complications three are renal stones, urinary tract infections, and rarely renal insufficiency. Okay, next one. Individuals with medullary sponge kidney are at increased risk for what? Kidney stones and urinary tract infection. That was an easy one. Next one. Blank is a congenital renal disorder characterized by cystic dilatation of the collecting tubules in one or both kidneys. Another easy one. Of course, the answer is medullary sponge kidney. Not all of them are this easy, so we've gotten really lucky. Let's see. Okay. So, it's going to start the video again. One second. So, if you go to osmosis.org, you're going to be able to see these amazing videos and the questions and the flashcards, and you can organize it so you have it all at your fingertips. Really, you don't have to leave Osmosis. A lot of times I study for a quiz or a test and I just stay within Osmosis or wherever it sends me for the entire time. So check it out, and thanks for joining me for this session. We're talking about medullary sponge kidney. I might be back very soon, so stay with me if you're interested in reviewing these kidney disorders, because I have a quiz coming up, and this is a great way that I review for the tests. So what are we going to listen to say goodbye here? Just looking down here. Oh, this is an old one.
Freakazoids, robots, please report to the dance floor.
Boy, this reminds me of when I was in high school. I used to go clubbing in Los Angeles at this place called Osco's, and also Florentine Gardens. Now, I graduated high school in 1984. How about something a little more modern? How about G-Funk by Nate? Thanks very much for joining me, and I'll be back again very soon to go over some more kidney disorders probably or other medical subjects. Thanks a lot.